Yeah, it's fraudulent art, it's fake, doesn't have a meaning, doesn't have a life. All it says to me is money.
I'm in Gastown in downtown Vancouver. It's a tourist hotspot known for its famous ski plot and shops selling Indigenous art. But we're not here to find good art. We're here to find fakes. To help us out, we've enlisted journalist Francesca Fionda. She's recently investigated the practice right here in Gastown.
So we visited 40 different shops. We sampled 260 different items. And what we learned was 75% of the stores that we visited were selling at least some inauthentic art.
To find out what's really happening, we're going to covertly film a souvenir shopping trip.
So this is probably one of the most, reproduced images in Vancouver. That specific image has been reproduced again and again without permission, no labels, nothing to show that they've paid for any, if they did, use a design.
During her investigation, Francesca contacted companies using Indigenous designs to see if they paid or collaborated with First Nations artists.
This is an example of a company that we reached out to and they don't collaborate with Indigenous artists, but they have pretty misleading labels.
Genuine native Indian craft, no connection.
It may be on the lower end of the art spectrum, but capturing the tourist dollar is very lucrative.
When we looked at this issue a few years ago, we learned that tourists are spending over $1 billion on things like souvenirs, gifts, clothing, and different items when they visit. So, a portion of that money is being diverted towards things that we saw in the stores, like fraudulent, inauthentic art.
$1 billion in British Columbia alone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's right. So across Canada, it's multi-billion dollar industry.
First Nations artists are understandably angry. Richard Hunt is one of Canada's most prominent Indigenous carvers. Yet he's constantly battling to stop his art being reproduced without his consent.
Well, I've been fighting this for at least 50 years. It's been a problem ever since I've been a carver. I don't care how good or bad or whatever that's been copied, it's anything I think should stop.
That's important.
Recently carved a totem pole similar to this one. The design was ripped off and screen printed onto canvas, then sold online by someone he had never met.
I seen that he was doing that and tried to go after him, but my lawyer told me don't bother because it's in public domain. I think every artist would be happy with somebody wanting to produce their work but counted them in. I own the copyright to my work and I own, amongst my people, I own the copyright. To non-native people, they don't even understand it.
And it's going to be a man's face in between his legs. Probably an eagle, baby eagle looking out.
One of the things I've always said is it's our culture. We own it. Like, they're figures that come down from my generations that are passed down to us.
How does all this impact on younger Indigenous artists coming through?
I think they'll probably get out of the market because there won't be any incentive for them to make a living doing that. If the government doesn't help us.
But there's a growing awareness around the issue. In March, Canadian police prosecuted 8 people for Indigenous art fraud worth an estimated $100 million.
We have seized more than 1,000 paintings, prints, and other art that were purported to be authentic, more so.
I think there are more and more high-profile cases of this happening, and it's making people think about, okay, how can we address this problem?